In honor de nuestra corporación LaCroix, and of course, Ralph Heath, and I'm president of Lockheed Martin Aeronautics, an occasion and also a happy one for many different reasons. States. It is the beginning of a chapter in Chile's Air Force. It is a milestone in the continuing friendship that exists between. You'll agree that it's truly inspiring. Lockheed Martin's Vice President of F-16 program.
Bienvenidos. Este es un gran día. Hemos puesto mucho fe en una realidad. What a great day this is. We've worked hard to make the F-16 for Chile a reality. The day has finally seen, and from other faraway places. At this time, I would like to recognize some of Chile's Minister of National Defense, the Honorable Jaime, Mr. Ralph Heath, President, Lockheed Martin Aeronautics, Mia Vilches, Commander-in-Chief of the Chilean Air Force, International Affairs, Mr. Ron Kovas, Lockheed Martin's President for the Americas Region, Commander of the Defense Contract Management Agency at the Air Force Plant No. 4, and our landlord. I mentioned all of them. Mrs. Lily Urdanola, wife of Ambassador Bianchi. Major General Richard Mentemeyer, Deputy Commander of U.S. Southern Command, representing the office of Senator John Cornyn. And John Balderston, Lockheed Martin Peace Puma Program Director. Members of the Chilean Air Force and the Chilean government who are here today to stand and be recognized as a group. Thank you, you are all our guest of honor. Please stand. At this time, I would like to make some comments about your F-16. Peace Puma, which now includes Chile, to ensure flawless integration of new capabilities into the aircraft as they emerge.
In 2005, the proud heritage continues with the acquisition of the Block 50 F-16, the 21st century fighter.
Building and supporting the finest fighter aircraft in the world. The aircraft you see before you joins the fleet of over 4,200 F-16s produced for 21 air forces around the world. This aircraft is the product of a technology insertion program that has kept the F-16 at the leading edge of fighter aircraft capabilities throughout its production life. The latest generation, full and advanced multi-role fighter available in the world today. The aircraft incorporates new 21st century military systems with the proven aerodynamic design that has made the F-16 one of the world's entire piece Puma program team that worked to make this day possible. Now, Mr. Bruce, International Military Programs, in his role as the Deputy Undersecretary of the Air Force for International Affairs, please join me in welcoming.
Thank you, June. Ambassador Bianchi, Minister Ravenet, General Sarabia, Lieutenant General Schmidt, all of our distinguished guests, and I think most importantly, General Michael Dominguez, and our Air Force Chief of Staff, General John Jumper, let me begin by saying that it is a distinct honor for me to participate in this historic event, the inauguration of Chilean F-16. Likewise, the program serves to enhance professional relationships and foster technical expertise as our nations train and equip for defense challenges, including the threat of terrorism throughout the world. It is especially symbolic that from early experiments in flight with the Wright brothers at Kitty Hawk and Chilean Cesar Copetta Brosio's first aircraft flight in 1910, we have developed into modern air forces flying one of the most capable fighters in the global inventory. Our highly skilled and the stability of the Western Hemisphere. Chilean Air Force aircrew continue to progress as one of the best trained and best equipped fighting forces in the region. I congratulate everyone who had a part in building and delivering these marvelous aircraft. This is a total team effort. Our Western Hemisphere, and indeed, I truly believe that our two air forces working together can help ensure such a goal. Very special day. Muchas gracias, mis amigos.
Thank you, Bruce, for those very appropriate comments. Next, we will hear from the U.S. Air Force. Incidentally, General Schmidt completed training and qualified in the F-16 just this February.
Ms. June Shrewsby, Mr. Corvey. Distinguished guests of Lockheed Martin Corporation and all the Chilean friends and all fans of the newest member of their ranks, the F-16. Now, my predecessors had worked with the Chilean Air Force on this project for about 3 years before I came aboard, and I know that they would be glad and proud to stand here today to be the Chilean flag. Now, today's rollout highlights General Sarabia's leadership in molding an Air Force of professionalism, pride, and the highest competency. I know the F-16 will find a good home, and it's fitting that today's milestone takes place during the year in which the Chilean Air Force celebrates its 75th anniversary. A few months ago, as I was just alluded to, Minister Ravenet was fortunate enough to receive a ride in the F-16, courtesy of the Taco New Mexico Guard, during the Chilean host exercise Salitre 04 several months ago. Now, he'd only been on the job for about 2 days, and we were able to suit him up and put him in an F-16 Block 30. As I read the press, I very fast. Well, I would like to add that it's not only very fast, but it presents 21st century capabilities, proven in combat relationship with the FACH. General Sarabia, I want you to know that you can always count on us. Gracias por su amistad y de nuevo felicidades. Gracias.
Thank you for being here with us and for your kind comments. Commander-in-Chief of the Chilean Air Force. General Sarabia has been in his current position since 2002 and has served in a variety of senior posts and commands in his career with the Fuerza Aérea de Chile. He is a cumulative pilot. He completed studies at the Air War College and holds a large...
I would like to sincerely thank you all for your kind invitation to the rollout of the first F-16 for the Chilean Air Force. This ceremony is a significant step in the acquisition and incorporation process of this aircraft to our inventory. We can realize that everything is running at schedule, and therefore we are closer to see this magnificent aircraft with our colors in Chile. We know that it will be accomplished successfully as it happened with the former stations. On behalf of the Chilean Air Force,
this project became to
the United States government officials, our colleagues and friends of the United States Air Force in ways. This aircraft that you see in front of us, I can assure you.
Thank you, General.
Language authorities, ladies and gentlemen, dear friends. Let me express my pleasure for the warm reception that we receive here in Fort Worth in this very significant and symbolic ceremony. Chile is a peaceful country, open to the world, with a vibrant democracy and a very solid economy. That it has helped to diminish our poverty rate by more than 50% during the last 15 years.